15 straight home wins, the new longest home win streak in program history for the Owls. A trip to the A-Sun Conference Tournament clinched last night with a 3-1 win over Stetson. It was a magical night at the Combo last night for Kennesaw State, but their focus now must turn to tonight. FGCU, a program at the start of the season teams feared, and rightfully so. 7-3 in the A-Sun and not yet out of reach for first place in the tie that currently sits atop of those A-Sun standings. One of, if not the biggest matches of the season for the Owls, Eagles versus Owls, coming up next here on the KSU Owl Network. Bryce Gobert alongside all-time leader in kills, Lauren Chastang. Lauren, a lot of fun on this game tonight. A lot of Owls had this game marked down on their calendar. Last season, a 3-1 win. What are the Owls going to need to do tonight to get the win?
Yeah, I think the Owls will never sleep on FGCU. FGCU has faced some adversity here in the past few weeks, but that doesn't mean that they're not as good as they were. It doesn't mean that they're going to come out playing lightly. A game between KSU and FGCU is always a brawl, and it's going to be really fun if you're here in the Convo to watch these teams go at it, because this is going to be a lot of high-level volleyball play tonight.
Grace Reynolds, Skylar English, and Ayana Battle, not with FGCU's traveling squad here tonight. Focusing now on key players, who do you have starting with FGCU that will have an impact tonight?
For FGCU, I have Erin Shoemaker. She was the A-Sun Player of the Year last year and preseason projected A-Sun Player of the Year this year. She's a force for her team. She's a six-row all-around outside hitter. She plays from the front row and the back row. She's going to give digs. She's also going to be a huge offensive threat, and I look for her to be FGCU's go-to girl.
And on the Kennesaw State side?
For Kennesaw State, if you were here last night, you saw Manu Johnson play lights out. She had a double-double, kills and digs. Coming off a big night like that, I expect her to still be hot and lead the Owls tonight on the offensive side of things.
We'll now step aside for the anthems and the starting lineups when we come back at FGCU versus Kennesaw State.
As a defensive specialist, the freshman from Lindsay Taylor.
Welcome back into the Convocation Center. Starting lineups just announced, as you just heard. Lauren Clark, Lily Feltz, Aaron Shoemaker, Dana Axner as the libero here tonight for FGCU. Emma Shipshack, Chelsea Lockley, Juliana Lentz is the starters for FGCU. For Kennesaw State, Leah Freeman, Claire Parsons, McKinley Ferguson, Jasmine Brown, Shelby Dennis, Manu Johnson, who had a monster night last night, and Emma Scherfranz, the starters here for Kennesaw State. Owls in their black uniforms with their gold trim, libero wearing the yellow, FGCU in their white cutoffs with the green numbers, blue shorts, and the blue armbands that fade into green. Libero for FGCU tonight will be, as I mentioned, Dana Axner wearing the blue jersey. Going to be a fun one to get started off here tonight after the football game. Kennesaw State took the victory over Charleston Southern 30-20, able to protect the nest. And the Owls volleyball team will look to do the same here. Couple final adjustments just getting underway. Lauren, we take a look at the series history before we get underway. FGCU leads all time in the series history, 10-4. The Owls actually won the last meeting here at the Convocation Center back on November 7, 2021, 3-1. However, FGCU is 7-3 against the Owls in the last 10, and 5-3 versus Kennesaw State at the Convocation Center.
It's always a good match between these two teams.
Scherfranz goes for the early kill and gets it. Owls on top early, 1-0. Exactly the start you're looking for there if you're Kennesaw State, setting the tone early.
Absolutely, and especially feeding Emma, who was a little bit more quiet last night. I love that they're getting her started early because they're going to need her tonight.
Shelby Dennis makes way. Claire Parsons and Jasmine Brown in. Far side for Clark. Looks like a net violation called on FGCU. Owls jump out to an early 2-0 lead. Last night in set number one, the Owls were defeated in a rare loss at home, set-wise, as Parsons again on the serve. Set by Lockie. Ferguson keeps it up, but just out of the reach of Leah Freeman. Aaron Shoemaker making her presence known early, the senior from Granville, Ohio. Lauren Clark, the senior from Chapman, Minnesota, 6 foot on the serve. Received by Dennis, popped up by Freeman. Far side, Manu Johnson, nice kill by her. Driving to save it was Dana Axner. And the Owls jump out to a 3-1 lead, excuse me, here in set number one. Emma Scherfranz on the serve here for Kennesaw State. Mentioned a quiet night. 4 sets played, 6 kills, 2 assists to her name last night. Popped up by Lockie. Far side for Shoemaker. Blocked at the net by Brown. Ferguson on the set. Deflection off the fingertips at the net of Lily Feltz. And the Owls get the point. Manu Johnson with 2 early kills here early on. Starting off where she picked up, where she left off yesterday. Scherfranz again with the top spin serve received by Axner. Set by Lockie. And a good kill there from Lily Feltz, but it'll get called back for a net violation. It was out of bounds, I believe.
Yeah, it looks like it went outside the antenna. It was a great kill. Just a little far outside for her. She tried to still turn it down the line and called for a pin violation.
Owls lead at 5-1 again. Scherfranz on her third straight serve. Hits the net. Axner diving to save it, but won't be able to. Emma Scherfranz gets the ace, and the Owls hitting 100 so, or 1,000 so far. FGCU hitting minus 250. Owls get the first ace of the night. Owls on a 3-0 scoring run. Scherfranz looks to make it 4-0. Axner receives. Kept up by the Owls on their side. Ferguson does the little fake. Gets it over, and she has a kill. First one on the night for her. 7-1 Owls.
If you're Kennesaw State, this is exactly what you want to see coming out, protecting the net, especially after the slow first set the time before, the night before. So this is exactly what you want to see, spreading the offense really well. And also, as you can see on the FGCU side, they're having trouble closing the block right now, and so we're able to spread the offense and get a lot of things hot tonight already.
FGCU takes the early timeout, and you mentioned that's exactly what Kennesaw State wanted. The fast start, weren't able to get the best start they had last night versus Stetson. But now tonight, early on, Manu Johnson with two kills, Ferguson with one, Sherfrons with one. I mean, you can't ask for a better start here if you're the Owls.
Yeah, really spread out. And FGCU came off a really, really tough win last night against Jacksonville State, which is a very hard team to beat. They went to five sets, so they could be feeling maybe a little fatigue, travel fatigue, whatever it might be. And so, you know, roles might be reversed here. They might be a little bit more slow starting, and I'm sure that their offense will get hot pretty fast as well.
You mentioned it last game. They played last night like Kennesaw State, but Owls didn't have to travel. FGCU took that one 3-2 in Jacksonville, Alabama. Won set number one, then lost two straight in sets two and three, and came back in the final two sets of 4 and 5 to claim that victory over Jacksonville State. We mentioned in the open that FGCU kind of on the outside looking in right now. Three teams tied atop the ASUN Conference standings at 9-2. FGCU currently tied for fifth. Kennesaw State and Lipscomb, the only two ASUN teams to clinch the postseason so far. FGCU 7-3 in the ASUN play. Sherfrons again on the serve. Just misses that outside line as we see some subs getting ready to come in for the Owls and Laney Van Treese and Caroline Cole. So FGCU gets a much needed point, 7-2 now here in set one from the Convocation Center. Dana Axner on the serve, the fifth year from Dublin, Ohio. Serve received by Cole, popped up far side. Manu Johnson, deflection, and falls to the floor.
She's getting off to a great start, seeing the block really well, not avoiding the block, but actually using the block to her advantage tonight.
Set two season highs last night in kills with 20 and points with 22 versus Stetson. Played in four sets and also had 16 digs to her name, and on the serve now. Received by Shoemaker. Phelps keeps it alive. Going to be put over by Clark. Johnson pops it up for Ferguson. Jasmine Brown put it over. FGCU bobbling around, keeps it up. Ferguson, Jasmine Brown kill attempt. FGCU able to keep it alive. Axner blocked, dug out by Freeman. Far side, Laney Van Treese just puts it over. Phelps will pop it up. Lockie this time, light tip over the net by number 9, Emma Shipshack. Owl's going to try and come back with it, and here we go back and forth again, just like we saw last night. Long rallies, popped over. Dennis received, Ferguson sets, far side, Van Treese gets the kill. Saw it last night, the Owls prevailed a lot on the long points, and they're doing it again here today.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're FGCU, you see Lily Feltz over here. She's trying to take some balls that I would say she needs to get outside and let herself be the hitter instead of trying to help the team get those out-of-system balls.
Owls currently on a 6-1 scoring run. Johnson on the serve, leaves it long. First service air on the night for either squad.
Looking for FGCU to settle down a little bit and control the chaos just a little bit better and get in their system that they're so used to playing in.
Ferguson tried to go for the fake again. Lockie pops it up. Feltz leaves it a little long. Thought maybe we got a tip from the Owls at the net. Did FGCU, but no tip was called. 10-3 the score. FGCU making some substitutions. Claire Earle, the middle blocker, the sophomore from Indianapolis, Indiana, making her way in. Played in five, had five or more matches in 2021 with five or more digs. Receives the serve there, Lockie. Clark finds that outside line over towards the Owls bench and gets FGCU back on the board, 10-4.
So that's the second kill tonight by FGCU. The other 2 points came from two errors on the Owls. So their offense is really low right now. It's not something that FGCU is used to having. So going with adversity tonight and seeing how they'll respond with that.
Manu Johnson with the light set over the net. Just misses the far sideline, this time over towards the FGCU bench. And another air there on the Owls, giving FGCU 3 points. Feltz on the serve one more time. Dennis receives a low set. Van Treese will go for the kill, blocked at the net, but lands out of bounds. Kennesaw State again gets a much-needed point to extend their lead back out to 6. Sherfrons makes her way back in for Caroline Cole. McKinley Ferguson on the serve here for the Owls. Leaves it a little long, and yet again another error on Kennesaw State that's giving FGCU 3 points. 11-6 now our score.
It's always a good thing, though, when you're so free that you can be more aggressive and have the errors and still be in a really comfortable spot as a team.
Rylan Reed served, hits the net short. So she came in for the serve. Now will be taken back out and entering back in will be Emma Shipshack and the libero, Dana Axner. Vantrese on the serve here for Kennesaw State, another Owl who set a season high with 14 kills versus Stetson last night. Clark here on the kill, attempt blocked to the net by Scherfranz and Parsons. Scherfranz pops it up, Johnson for the kill. Axner able to keep it up. Lockie Phelps this time, right at Shelby Dennis. Ferguson set for Vantrese, blocked at the net. Dennis keeps it alive again. Johnson this time going to be put over by Scherfranz. Axner popped it up, Lockie on the set. Phelps misses on the outside, Owls get the point.
Some high level, great volleyball like we expected tonight. Some amazing digs right there by Shelby Dennis. Some amazing plays by Lily Phelps, and just one went a little bit too long.
Vantrese again on the serve. Off the shoulder of Lily Phelps, not received cleanly, and give that an ace to Lainey Vantrese. Actually, her first ace on the season. Never too late to get one of those. Owls lead at 14-6. Phelps receives this one cleanly. Lockie pops it up. Blocked at the net by a couple of Owls, and here comes Clark again. Slam leaves it long on the kill. They're going to call a deflection, however, and FGCU will get the point. Coming back into the game for Claire Ertl will be number six, Aaron Shoemaker. Shoemaker has a great story from her first, or from last season, I should say. A-Sun Player of the Year, A-Sun Tournament and Most Outstanding Player. A lot of accolades to her names and looking to add more to it this season. Ferguson will set. Scherfranz gone to kill. Finds that far side line and in.
Love it. I love how it started with the pass from the freshman, Leah. You know that the ball's going to come to you if you're the freshman on the court, and she handled it so well. Set it right on top of McKinley's head and dished right, greatly right to Emma Scherfranz.
Addie Godey in on the serve. Shoemaker receives it. Lockie pops it up. Going to have to be put over by Shoemaker. Light tip over. Ferguson keeps it alive. Godey on the set. Scherfranz, a light little tap over it. And here comes Clark. Deflection again off the Kennesaw State player's fingers over there. Couldn't quite tell who it was. But FGCU and the Eagles get the point.
Coach Keith verifying, did y'all actually touch it or not? A moment where you have to tell the truth.
Smiling over there, saw him talking for a long time with head coach Matt Botsford of FGCU. Owls, what a dig there from Shelby Dennis. Had 30 of them last night. Another one there. McKinley Ferguson couldn't get low enough. Good kill attempt, or good kill, I should say, by number 13, Juliana Lintz. And FGCU closes that lead back to 6, 15-9. Clark on the serve. Freeman receives it. Ferguson will set. Far side, Manu Johnson. Great diving effort from Dana Axner. Freeman one more time gets low. Johnson, kill, blocked at the net, kept alive. Owls got to put it over. They will with Leah Freeman. Axner, set by Lockie. Deflection able to be kept up by the Owls. Jasmine Brown tried to go for the kill attempt. Long rally there. The Owls aren't able to get the point out of it. And FGCU on the way back. 15-10 here in set one. Owls with 8 kills so far. FGCU with 5 and a service error there from Lauren Clark. Had 1 ace in her last game along with 9 kills and a .269 hitting percentage. Scherfranz back on the serve here for Kennesaw State. Hard serve with the topspin received by Axner. Great kill there from number 13, Juliana Lintz. Had 92 coming into today. Make that her second this evening.
When FGCU handles the first ball so well like that, it's going to be really hard to stop them. So Kennesaw has to stay aggressive with their serve, but that was a great first contact by Dana Axner right there.
Axner on the serve. Ferguson pops it over, hits the net, and rolls out of bounds. So just like that, we have a 4-point game, 16-12. Eagles not going anywhere. Cole will receive, Ferguson will set. Jasmine Brown for the kill. Great set there from McKinley Ferguson. As I mentioned last night, had 53 of those assists. Season high of 61 versus Central Arkansas back on September 24th. Here's Manu Johnson again. Owls extend their lead back out to 5, 17-12. Light serve, Axner will take. Set by Lockie. Johnson there to keep it up. We'll go back over. Light set. Shoemaker blocked at the net. FGCU and Axe are going to have to put it over. Owls will be in system to try and set it up. Manu Johnson, deflection and kill. Trying to get up to block. It was Emma Shipshack. Hit off the edge of her hand and onto the floor.
Such great timing right there by Manu Johnson and McKinley Ferguson. That pipe set is so quick. It almost acts as if it is a two out of the middle. And that timing was just so perfect and so beautiful.
Johnson again on the serve. Axner will take it. Lockie will set here for Feltz, right in between the hands of Manu Johnson and Shelby Dennis. Lead cut back down to 5. Shoemaker on the serve. 17 aces on the season. Leads FGCU in points and kills. 318 kills and 354 points this year. Laney Van Treese, kill attempt gets blocked. Feltz again, blocked at the net by the Owls and lands out of bounds. Just rolled across the net and over to that far side
line.
We'll
see if Coach Keith challenges that one. Looks like he dropped the challenge card.
He did drop the challenge card, and he will go to it. So we're going to have a little timeout here to see if that one actually did land in bounds. Saw Lanny Van Treese over there pleading her case. Thought it did land in bounds. So going to try the challenge. 18-14 our score here in set number one from the Convocation Center. Owls and Eagles. Lauren, playing in this against this team for so long, you know them so well. As we take a quick look at the replay here, Feltz on the block, or Feltz on the kill. Johnson, or that's Brown and Ferguson. Ball still traveling, and gonna be hard to tell where it hits the floor.
So if it touches any side of the line, it doesn't matter if it's just like the last little tiny bit of the ball, anything on the line, it will be called in.
From that angle, it looked pretty good in favor of Kennesaw State. Here comes the call. And the point will go to Kennesaw State, so the score will change 19-13. Owls back in front.
I would say that's a good call by Coach Keith to challenge that ball. It's going to keep the offense over here really frustrated.
Owls didn't challenge any calls last night. Kind of just went with the flow. Left that challenge card in the Stetson hand. Didn't have many of them from the Stetson side either. So 19-13, set number one. Shelby Dennis on the serve. 17 aces coming into this weekend. Lily Feltz fired it over towards Shelby Dennis. Got one hand on it and deflected out of bounds. Hard to tell if that one would have gone out if it got down, but FGCU gets the point.
I think Lily Feltz really wanted another opportunity to prove herself after getting the challenge of a block being in.
Here she is on the serve. Dennis receives it. Ferguson sets it far side for Laney Van Treese. Deflection at the net. Owls get the point. Scherfron's on her way back in. Matt Botsford doesn't look like he's going to pull out the challenge card. 265 record, 200 wins, 65 losses in his ninth season as Eagles head coach. Ferguson on the serve, received by Ertl. Feltz again on the serve, dug out of there by Dennis. Ferguson rushes back up to set it. And it looks like Ferguson, whatever she was doing, so foot crossed the line. And FGCU will again keep this lead within 5. 20-15, set number one, Bryce Gobert, Lauren Chastain from the Convocation Center. We appreciate you taking your time on your Saturday to tune in here on the KSU Owl Network. Rylan Reed back in to serve, 11 aces on the year coming into tonight. Ferguson sets, Van Treese kill. Nice job by Lockley to keep it up. Ferguson one more time, this time goes short set. Reed keeps it alive, Feltz this time. Ferguson popped up, Dennis popped up. Scherfron's kill attempt, finds the corner and in. 21-15.
A beautiful turn right there by Emma Scherfons. Not too much heat on it, but just a super smart play of, hey, I see this, it's open. My power shot's not open, and I'm just keep it high and stroke it down the line.
Lainey Van Treese on the serve. Finds the back line and has her second ace on the night and the year. Owls finding ways to make things work here in set one. 22-15, they lead. Van Treese again. Lockie on the reception. Clark on the kill attempt, gets in bounds. Claire Parsons and Emma Scherfrantz combine for the block. 23-15. Timeout taken by the Eagles, and we'll step aside. Kennesaw State comes out firing here in set number one versus FGCU. When we come back, the final couple points here in the set. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Kennesaw State Women's Volleyball here on the KSU Owl Network. John Davis, our net judge here tonight. Kittilax Kradockorn, referee two on the far side. Scott Thompson, line judge one. And Sean Muhammad, line judge number two here tonight for this matchup between the Owls and Eagles. And Lauren, we were just talking about this team last night has a different energy at the start than they had last night.
Oh my gosh, absolutely. They look powerful, they look calm, they look confident, and that's always a great thing.
Van Treese gonna have to save it. She will. Scherfrantz will put it over. Axner, Lockie, nice tip over by FGCU. Owls able to keep it up. Dennis will put it over. Great save attempt by Lockie. Van Treese this time pops it up. Dennis one more time. Will it get over the net? It's just short, but someone on the far side will put it over. Clark with a light tip falls to the ground. FGCU prevails in that long rally. 23-16.
A great effort play right there. By both teams right there, honestly.
Teams running all over the place out of the gray area that surrounds the court, or that marks the court in the white lines. New court here for Kennesaw State that just was installed a couple years ago. Ferguson will set. Scherfrantz goes for the back line, gets in. What a play there from Emma Scherfrantz.
What a beautiful spot. Like the time before, just she sees those corners are open. I'm sure that they've scouted that too, and she's such a smart player and has that perfect little touch where she can do that.
Addie Godey in for the serve. One to go here for Kennesaw State as the fans rise to their feet with the one finger in the air. Received by Shoemaker. Set by Lockie at the net. Finding the back line on the far side was Lauren Clark. Leads her team in kills tonight with that being her fifth. She'll get the serve now. Received by Dennis, set by Ferguson. Scherfrantz kill, finds the floor. Owls take set one. Couldn't have asked it for anything better for Kennesaw State. Owls done a fantastic job here, and they're up early at the Convocation Center. Lauren, what a performance here in set number one by the Owls.
What a performance. They were definitely just offensively handling everything really well. We never really felt like Kennesaw was on their heels, right? And we felt that FGCU was on their heels many times and scrambling to make plays happen. And it's tough when your back's against the wall like that with a team like Kennesaw that's really, really hot right now.
Teams will switch sides. We'll step aside. Set number two on its way here from the Convocation Center. Don't go anywhere. You won't want to miss it.
Thank you. Myself.
Claire.
Claire.
Maggie.
Me.
Claire.
Shelby.
Chelsea. 100% Chelsea.
I would say probably Shelby.
Lou.
Claire.
Maybe Danny. I think she just like does it, but like doesn't really like think about it, that sort of thing.
Chelsea.
Shelby.
All of them. Probably Claire or Caroline. We all do weird things.
Kennesaw State, the only team tied for first place playing tonight. Lipscomb play Liberty tomorrow at 1 p.m. That'll be a really fun and interesting game to see how it'll play out. But now here at Kennesaw State, Owls take set number one in pretty convincing fashion. 14 kills compared to FGCU's 10. Owls hitting 367, FGCU only hitting 125. Lauren, what stands out?
Yeah, I think that the offensive side of things, you have Kennesaw hitting 367, 125. We're seeing a lot. Most of FGC points came from the errors of the Owls, from a serve standpoint or from just little silly things, right? And so that means that FGCU has to find a way to produce to be able to be the ones in control and earning their own points, because that's what's going to give them the momentum.
Six errors came from the Kennesaw State side that gave FGCU points. Nonetheless, Owls take it 25-17. Mentioned they switch sides, switch benches. Pretty similar starting. And set number two was in set number one for both sides, if not the same. Again, couple of final things just getting clarified here. Owl's going to get the serve first.
Yeah, both teams are going to be really used to, I mean, you see if you look over at FGCU, they're still really loose. Both teams are very used to adversity, playing in high-level environments, and this is nothing new to either of them, so each match is going to feel like the start of something.
Leah Freeman on the serve. Don't receive. Johnson goes up for a block. Nice dig out of there from Leah Freeman, trying to find the corner. And it looks like we're going to have a net violation, I believe. Not quite sure what the call was there. Eagles got the point.
I think everyone's a little bit confused.
Still trying to figure out what here was. Hasn't been updated in the live stats yet. FGCU takes the lead. And an ace there from Dana Axner. So FGCU coming out fast. 2-0 early on. Axner one more time on the serve. Bounces it a couple times, gets ready. Far back from the line, Freeman will receive it. Ferguson on the set, Scherfranz on the light tap over. Lockie will receive. Axner pops it up, far side for Shoemaker. Deflection off a couple of Owls' hands at the net of Parsons and Scherfranz. And down onto the floor, FGCU jumps out to a 3-0 lead. Similar to what Kennesaw State looked like in set number one, FGCU doing early here in set number two. Freeman keeps it up. Ferguson on the set. Johnson with the light tap over. Axner pops up. Shoemaker again. Freeman digs it out. Johnson on the kill. Blocked at the net. Shelby Dennis keeps it alive. Ferguson. Claire Parsons didn't get Oliver Muster on it. We'll go up for the block and get it to fall. Emma Scherfranz and Claire Parsons combined. Looks like they're going to give credit to just Emma Scherfranz. Parsons jumps up too, but hit the hands of Claire Parsons. Addie Godey on her way in, replacing Claire Parsons.
Some sweat spots on the floor.
Getting those cleaned up. Addie Godey last night played in all four sets, had two assists and one dig. Multiple two-assist games this season. Leaves that serve long as Dennis and Parsons will get ready to come back in. 4-1 Eagles lead here in set number two. Lauren Clark, 21 aces coming into tonight. Going to be on the serve here for the Eagles. Dennis gets low, gets it. McKinley Ferguson on a bad set there to Jasmine Brown. Brown went up for it and didn't quite meet her over there. 5-1 at Owls Trail here. Clark again on the serve. Leaves it long on that one, so the Owls getting some points off some airs here.
Yeah, it almost feels like roles reverse a little bit. The points for the Owls are coming from the airs from the Eagles. And the Eagles are more in rhythm, and the Owls are out of rhythm right now. So they've switched sides and switched roles right now.
Scherfranz going to be serving here for Kennesaw State. Hard serve with a lot of topspin. Nice job on the reception from Ertl. Ferguson will set. Jasmine Brown finds the floor in the middle. Owls bringing it back. They close the lead to two. Brings their kill total up to 15. Scherfranz tonight, 5 kills, 1 ace, 1 dig, and 2 blocks, hitting 556. Dennis dives and keeps it alive. Ferguson, Johnson will go up to meet it. Axner now diving to keep it alive as well. Light tip over. Jasmine Brown on the floor to keep it up. Chaos all over the combo. One more time kept up, this time by Dennis. Johnson for the kill. Axner able to pop it up and keep it alive. This time felt Freeman there.
Bummer. You hate when a play like that with so many bodies going everywhere, everyone's playing out of their minds, it just ends with like a net call.
Not what the Owls were looking for. Head coach Keith Schunzel not happy with it and going to pull out that challenge card again. So we're going to get a chance to take a look at it. He wants that point. I guess it'd be replayed, correct? Since, I mean, it was called.
I think he's challenging that there was no net violation and it was the ball. Let's see.
There's Jasmine Brown
there. She touched the net. I think it was the ball that touched the net.
It's hard to see if maybe her pinky right there did.
No, I don't think she touched the net.
It's going to be a close call here. So two close calls here early on. So you see her hands right there. Ball crosses the net. Hands are going over. And maybe it's that, like I said, it has to be, if anything, that pinky right there. But here's the other thing. It has to be clear and obvious. That's a big thing in sports. Call on the way, and it will go. Kennesaw State will get the point. Okay, that's what we thought. So no point for Kennesaw State, 5-3 still the score. Point will just be replayed. So two successful challenges here early on by head coach Keith Schunzel. Scherfranz on the serve. Lockie on the reception. receiving that Ertl on the reception. Locky on the set. Ferguson will just try and tip it over. Popped up again. Felt this time. That one just misses from Lily Felt. Owls, it looked like Shelby Dennis over there might have gotten a touch on it, but pulled her hand away just in time for the ball to land out of bounds. Owls, close as they've been in this set, only trail by one. Axner goes low. Locky sets. Shoemaker. Freeman receives it. Ferguson for Johnson, blocked at the net by Locky. Shoemaker again, this time blocked out of bounds and over towards the scorer's table. So the point will go to FGCU. What's it like, Lauren, being a hitter and having all of these shots just keep getting blocked for both sides?
Yeah, I mean, you have to stay in a good mindset, a good place mentally, because it doesn't change. Your role doesn't change, and the opportunities are still the same. The court stays the same size. You just have to find ways to produce somewhere.
Feltz fires it at Dennis, who goes low. Johnson with the light tap. Ertl pops it up. Shoemaker and Feltz will put it over. Finding the back corner. What a shot there from Lily Feltz. Had Laney Van Treese diving to try and save it, but didn't have a chance. And just like that, FGCU's back on top by three. Shoemaker on the serve. Popped up by Dennis. Set by Ferguson. Jasmine Brown with the light tap. Axner there to keep it alive. Dennis digs it. Johnson pops it up. Put over by Ferguson. Diving to keep it was Axner. Shoemaker this time. Nice job by Cole to keep that one alive. Hit off the net by Manu Johnson. Going for the block is Jasmine Brown and McKinley Ferguson. But on the back line, FGCU gets the point off a deflection, I believe, off Laney Van Treese.
Lockley's really running her team offense really well right now. She's using her back row players, and their timing is really well. And then she's sending it out to the outside. She's using a lot of offensive options right now, which is keeping Kennesaw on their heels, on their toes, and having to try to figure out where the ball is actually going to go.
Owls take a timeout. We'll step aside and come back with more action from set number two from the Convocation Center. Owls lead the game, match 1-0. But FGCU leads here in set number 2 by 4. Convocation Center at GCU. After the night trip from Jacksonville, Alabama, after defeating Jacksonville State 3-2 in 5 sets, playing a tough one here against the Owls. They lead it 8-4. Shoemaker on the serve. Dennis receives it, but not cleanly. Popped it up. Ferguson didn't have a chance for it. And FGCU extends their lead to 5. Aaron Shoemaker and FGCU on the 3-0 scoring run. 4-0 now. Lands out of bounds, and it looks like a challenge card going to be coming in from Matt Botsford. FGCU claiming touch before it went out of bounds on Kennesaw State.
Yeah, I couldn't see it from our angle over here, but I think that they think that it hit Jasmine's foot on the way down.
They seemed pretty adamant on it, and he went directly for that challenge card. As of now, Owls trail by 4. So here's Jasmine Brown, blocked by Feltz. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that does touch Jasmine Brown. It looks like it, well, we'll see from this angle. That's a tough one again from the angle from the backside. It looked like it definitely touched her, but I'm looking here from the net cam. Looking for that touch right at the end off of Jasmine Brown's right foot.
I think this is where you're going to be able to tell more so.
So Felt gets the block.
I don't know.
That's a very close call. Again, clear and obvious it has to be.
I think if anything, it hit her high knee, high shin.
Kennesaw State gets the point, so challenge unsuccessful from head coach Matt Botsford. Played volleyball at Trine University from 1995 to 98 and is the program all-time leader in kills, digs, and blocks. Owls trail by 4-9-5. Manu Johnson on the serve. Axner to receive. Lockie on the set. Deflection off Amy Van Treese's hands. And out of bounds.
A great high swing by Shipshack going around on the slide right there. Didn't try to yank it down into the block. Instead, she just stayed high and stayed really smart right there.
Ryland Reed. Serve over to Caroline Cole. Ferguson pops it up. Jasmine Brown, quick kill. Owls fighting from behind, 10-6. Shelby Dennis on the serve here for Kennesaw State. Ertl will receive. Lockie on the set. Hey, nice job by Caroline Cole to keep it alive. Point will go over to the FGCU on a pin violation.
Great effort right there by McKinley.
Tried to keep it alive, and you saw she was going into that hard. And,
okay. Coach Keith tried to guard her.
Yeah, Coach Keith went over real quickly to try and make sure she didn't go sliding into that far video board. Rainey Van Treese on a deflection at the net from Juliana Lintz. Tried to go for the block and just hit off her hand and fell to the floor. Back trailing by four. Emma Scherfranz enters and McKinley Ferguson will serve. Team leader and assist here for Kennesaw State came into the weekend with 721 of them.
Verifying a little bit of rotation over here for FGCU, if they're standing in the right place.
Ferguson had to wait, bounces it a couple times, and finally put it up. Shoemaker leaves it high. Clark with the light tip over. Ferguson there to just take it. Van Treese will have to put the light tap over. Blocked at the net. Dennis had to dig it out of there. Manu Johnson on the kill, lands just out of bounds. Close call. And the lead is back out to five.
I feel as if Kennesaw is starting to find the rhythm again here and there. Hopefully we get Claire Parsons going a little bit right here. She only has two attempts and no kills so far, and I think that would really help Kennesaw's offense.
Ferguson sets. Van Treese goes for the kill. Hits off the net and falls to the floor. Fooled Lauren Clark. Wasn't quite ready for that one.
Yeah, the net can either be your friend or your enemy.
No in between. And unpredictable as always. Van Treese on the serve. Kept alive by Axner, set by Lockie, far side Shoemaker on the far outside part of the line towards that Owls bench. And the Owls had it within one at one point in this match, but struggling to get it between four or less than four. They've had it up the lead close to four, but right now it's just back and forth between the two, between five and four. Claire Parsons, there you go, Lauren, just mentioned it. Need to get Claire Parsons going. Gets a kill right there. First one on the night.
Yep, absolutely. It's only going to help the other hitters for Kennesaw be more open and be more available to have more open court to be able to execute their swings.
Addie Godey to serve here for Kennesaw State. Shoemaker had to get low to receive it. Blocked at the net by Brown and Scherfranz. Set by Ferguson to Brown. Tipped over. FGCU. And Clark blocked at the net by Johnson and Brown. Coach Keith liked that one a lot.
Yep, it's a good thing to get momentum going. FGCU was covering. They were just covering really short.
Addie Godey one more time on the serve. Getting low was Feltz at the net. Blocked at the net by Emma Scherfranz and Jasmine Brown, who were both there, but landing out of bounds. FGCU gets the point right back. So the Owls close the lead to 3, but FGCU right back, extending it to 4. Lauren Clark. Received by Dennis. Far side for Scherfranz, right at Dana Axner. Feltz this time blocked at the net. Back on the other side. And the Owls get the point. Jasmine Brown and Emma Scherfranz doing what they do best, having a net front presence. To 14-11. Emma Scherfranz with her third block on the night. That one hit into the net by Scherfranz. Looks like they'll call that one a block assist, so 2 blocks.
Yep, so if there's ever, even if you are not anywhere near the ball, but your feet leave the ground, you get half the credit.
Freeman for Johnson. Off the net, and you mentioned it earlier, may not be always your friend, may not be, or may be your enemy. That time it was Manu Johnson's friend.
Absolutely. I love how she's staying high tonight. She's not pulling it into the block. She knows that there's a big block in front of her, but she's still staying high and finding the open in the court.
5 kills through 2 sets. 2.5 sets, or 1.5 sets, I should say. Shoemaker will put it over. Dennis will pop it up. Ferguson will do her fake. FGCU able to return it, and this time will put it over. Lands way far out of bounds. Owls now within 2. Good crowd on here at the Convocation Center for the football game. A lot of energy here in the convo tonight. Lauren, I mean, this is exactly what we expected from these two teams, a hard-fought battle. Not going to be easy for either one of them, and neither team is making it easy for either one of them. I mean, you had Kennesaw State giving away a couple of points on airs in set number 1, and FGCU did the same thing early on here in set number 2, but what a game we have on our hands.
Yeah, what a game. I mean, Kennesaw is picking right back up where they left off last night. You have Emma Scherfranz hitting 500. Lane Pintries is hitting 714 right now. 333. You have a lot of high hitting percentages coming from the Kennesaw side of things. And then, like I mentioned earlier, FGCU has been going through some adversity, so I'm sure their lineup has changed some. They've lost some key players here and there. But they have a lot of veterans out there, too. And so even though maybe things aren't gelling as much as they would like them to, they're not going to go away, and Kennesaw feels that. You feel like Kennesaw has the momentum right now, but then again, Kennesaw's down by 2.
Without Grace Reynolds, Skylar English, and Ayana Battle tonight, our FGCU didn't travel with the team, but if you look at it, Kennesaw State on the season averages a hitting percentage of 257, and right now they're at 333, so above average for what they're normally doing. They hold opponents to a relatively low number of 196. So anytime you hold an opponent to below on the season, average an opponent on the season under 200 hitting percentage, you're doing something right.
Absolutely.
Johnson on the serve, fires it into the net. The Owls can clean up these errors that they're having. It'll do a lot for them. It'll make this a lot closer. Rylan Reed back in to serve. Cole receives. Dennis pops up. Vantrese near side. Off the fingertips at the net. Feltz blocked by Jasmine Brown. Vantrese couldn't pop it up well enough. Brown tried to dive and save it, but hit it on the underside of the net. That FGCU lead is extended back out to 4, 17-13 here in set 2. Cole goes low. Ferguson throws it over. FGCU will return. Blocked at the net by Brown and kept alive. Feltz one more time. Hit over towards us, but looks like it didn't hit an Owl's fingertip. It just hit off the net and rolled down all the way and out of bounds. So Owls finding a friend in that net. FGCU finding an enemy.
Yep. Lily Phelps is a little frustrated right now. I think that she just needs to continue swinging for her team. It's all you can do in these situations.
Early goes low, Locky sets. Johnson kept it alive. And out of bounds, FGCU will get the point. 18-14, lead back out to four. Chelsea Locky on the serve, leads FGCU in assist and aces, has 892 assists and 32 aces coming into tonight. Ferguson sets, Johnson from the back line, finds the back line.
What a beautiful set right there. Manu Johnson was already in the air, just locked and loaded, ready to attack on that ball. A great connection right there by McKinley Ferguson and Manu Johnson.
Ferguson to serve here for Kennesaw State. Owls not going away. Serve in the air. Locky on the set. Clark kept up by the Owls. Going to have to be put over by Ferguson, and it will be. Locky again on the set. This side for Clark finds the back line. Coach Keith happy with it, but Owls going to lose the point, 19-15. Lily Feltz on the serve. Fifth year from Knoxville, Tennessee. Ferguson sets. Claire Parsons finds the floor again.
Great swing by Claire.
Three attacks on the night. Go ahead.
Yeah, luckily just protecting herself there. Nothing you can do about that.
And Treese will make way for Freeman. Parsons with her fourth attack on the night. Now hitting 500 with her second kill. Freeman serve, Axna goes low. Clark blocked by Johnson. Axna to put it over. Scherfron tried to just put it down on the floor and ended up doing it, but on her own side.
Those are like the best balls to get, and sometimes can be the hardest balls to get because they're so high. The timing has to be so perfect. You got to stay out of the net. You're looking up. You don't really know where you are in terms of trajectory.
Ferguson to set. Johnson with the leg tip over. Far side. Clark. Ferguson on a hard hit. Ball popped high in the air. Scherfron's kill attempt blocked at the net. Couple of Eagles go diving for it and kept alive. Shoemaker will put it over. Ferguson sets. Far side. Manu Johnson blocked. Kept alive. Parsons puts it over, but I believe they're going to call a lift. And that is what the call is. Almost a great play there from Claire Parsons. 21-16, FGCU leads.
This is where it gets hard for me sitting over here and having to be quiet. That play was just so intense, so many things happening and big digs, big scrappy moments. And this is exactly what people will come to the Convo to see.
Kennesaw State trail by 5, 16-21. Eagles lead when we come back. The final stages of set number two. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Kennesaw State Women's Volleyball here on the KSU Owl Network. Here at the Convocation Center, Kennesaw State trails by 5 to FGCU. Made the night trip over from Jacksonville to play in a crucial A-Sun matchup. Freeman receives, Ferguson sets, Scherfron kill attempt blocked at the net. Feltz will set it up. Johnson keeps it alive, Dennis will do the same. Scherfron to put it over, Axner goes low to keep it up. Shoemaker blocked at the net, but out of bounds it lands. Now a 6-point lead here for FGCU.
She's so good. I don't even know how she she made contact with that ball going over the net. It was such an awkward set, but of course she flattened out her hand really well and pushed it right through that block.
Seeing a bunch of players here tonight for both squads all over the place. 26 digs for FGCU, 24 here for Kennesaw State. And actually, it just changed on me. 28 for FGCU, 25 for Kennesaw State. Here late on in set number two. Freeman, Scherfranz now. Far side for Manu Johnson. Goes for the back line, but left it a little long. Feltz kept it alive for FGCU. Freeman. Ferguson trying to set Parsons. She'll fake it one more time. Johnson, bunch of blocks at the net here for the Eagles. Johnson again. Blocked at the net, but gets it over the fingertips of Clark and Emma Shipshack.
I love that swing by Manu. She typically keeps her left shoulder close to the net, so she swings power, mostly everything cross court. She tried to actually turn her wrist that time, and that's why she tooled that block. She tried to turn it down the line right there, and that was really smart by her.
Addie Godey again into the game to serve here for Kennesaw State. Feltz not happy with how she received the serve, but kept it up for her team. Ferguson on the set, near side. Manu Johnson again takes a deflection off a fingertip at the net. Owls battling back, 22-18, the lead closed back down to four. Timeout called here by FGCU. Owls on the momentum swing right now, trying to find a way.
I think that went off of Shipshack's head, so there's not much you can do about that. If you're a blocker, you're like, sorry, guys.
Manu Johnson pacing the Owls tonight here and kills with eight on 21 attacks and 286. Six digs to her name as well as a block. Emma Scherfranz not far behind with six kills on 15 attacks and hitting 400. You look over on the FGCU side, though, Lily Feltz has six kills but hitting negative 53 on the night, tied in a three-way tie with Aaron Shoemaker for six kills and Lauren Clark with six as well.
Yep, if you're FGCU, you know, Lily Feltz is a fifth-year. She's a veteran, and so she's going to stay out there. She's a leader for her team, and she brings a lot of good things. You're going to have nights where you struggle to have a great hitting percentage, right? But you are still making a lot of noise on the Kennesaw side and getting them out of the system a lot. And she does a lot of things. She's a six-row player. She passes, she serves, she hits. And so if you're Lily, I would just, you know, continue to use your opportunities the best you get, and maybe you do something on the passing, serve, receive, and serving wise, right? So giving in another way, and then obviously FGC is looking for someone to kind of take that charge like you see on the Kennesaw side. You have Manu that's leading the way. There's no one really leading the way right now for FGCU.
FGCU trying to close out set number two and avoid going down 2-0. Cody again on the serve, received by Feltz. Did a better job that time. Blocked high up into the air by Brown and Scherfranz. Ferguson will set. Scherfranz with a light tap. Hits the pen. So a pen violation, 23-18. Lauren Clark to serve again here for the Eagles. Freeman receives the serve. Ferguson behind her to Scherfranz. Great kill there. Well, it looks like...
looked like that was Lockley that did a setter's dump just a little bit to the right of the back line right there. Not a bad option because no one was there. It was just a little bit long.
Owls get the point, 23-19. Scherfranz on the top spin made Axner go low. Scherfranz pops up. Set by Ferguson, popped long and in. Manu Johnson, seen that a lot from her, and Emma Scherfranz tonight just finding those back corners. 20-23, FGCU still leads. Hurdle on the serve reception. Finding the back line on the near side, on the far side was Aaron Shoemaker. And match point now here for FGCU. Trying to close it out, Shoemaker to serve. Leaves it long, gives the Owls a sign of life. Here comes Lainey Van Treese in for Leah Freeman. Manu Johnson to serve. 3-point game here in set number two, 24-21. Johnson jumps and serves, Feltz receives. Locky on the serve, Feltz again finds the back corner and FGCU takes set number two. 25-21, Kennesaw State unable to get set number two and go up 2-0. So we're back tied at 1-1, just like we were last night here, Lauren, after two sets. Anything different you see in set number two there versus set number one?
I think that FGCU started making a more of a clean first contact with the ball, allowing Lockley to get her team in better positioning for attacking the ball and killing the ball and putting it away.
Kennesaw State looking to go up 2-1 here in set number three. When we come back, a little bit longer of a break between sets two and three. Don't go anywhere. This is Kennesaw State Women's Volleyball on the KSU Travel Network.
Shelby.
Probably be. But it depends. Addie doesn't like to be rushed, so she'll take her time.
True.
But I just do a lot of...
Do you have a lot of steps?
Yeah, I have a lot of steps. Probably Addie.
Yeah. College turns
she's
me.
She's the aesthetic kind of girl. I'm just the throw it in a place and call it a day.
Neither of us.
Yeah.
We don't
do feelings.
No. Shelby. For sure.
I think it's different humor.
Yeah, different styles. She's just very quick. Like she can pop one out pretty fast.
My heart. Thank you.
You're welcome. I started in fifth grade. So
I probably did too.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 10 years now.
Oh!
Wow.
Probably
Shelby, yeah. I got a super speeder.
Speeder over here.
Probably Shelby.
I don't think I'm great, but I cook more than I think you do.
Yeah. Shelby.
It is me.
It's a neat messy though. For sure. I don't go to bed before like 2 a.m.
Yeah,
during the season, that changes. But like over the summer, like I will stay up as late as possible. When I first got here on my visit, Coach Schendel was like super positive and I got to watch their practice a little bit and I liked the way that they organized things and like go super hard for a short amount of time. I love that I have my own room and bathroom. That's pretty nice. I don't have to share with anybody. I wouldn't care to share, but it's nice to have my own stuff. I sweat a lot, like a whole lot. So I'm like, I get super wet. I have to like mop the floor up when I dive and stuff. So. In the sixth grade, I tried out for the Norse Middle School volleyball team. It's called Torculator, but that sounds kind of inappropriate. That's what gets me going, so. Because we're going to be awesome, and we're going to win a conference title. Just saying. Thank you.
just about to get underway here in set number three. Kennesaw State and the Florida Gulf Coast Eagles tied at one apiece in sets. FGCU takes set number two, 25-21. I'm going to take a look here at some key players that we mentioned earlier on in pregame. Manu Johnson, 9 kills, 318 hitting percentage, 6 digs, and 1 block to her name. Having a great game here for Kennesaw State. Like I said earlier, picking up where she left off last night.
Yep, exactly. She's hot this weekend, there's no doubt, and McKinley is nothing short of being very smart of continuing to feed her tonight, because we talked about this at the very beginning of the game. She's a key player for Kennesaw to come out and for them to be able to beat FGCU tonight.
On the other side, Erin Shoemaker playing fantastic. Tie with Lily Felton, the lead for kills, 7 of them, hitting 333 on the night, 1 assist, 1 ace, 5 digs, and a block to her name as well. So both of these players shining out for their team. Both are loose coming in here to set number three, both ready to go. We talked about it a little bit before. We said there's a very high chance this one goes 5 sets. And with how we're playing right now, with how both these squads are playing right now, it looks like we're well on our way.
Roles kind of reversed at the beginning of both sets. I think Kennesaw was up 6-1, and then FGCU started out 6-1. And we'll see if they start out more even kill this third set.
Lily Feltz to start us off here in set three. Transfer from Tennessee. It's a 2021 fall SEC academic honor roll. Johnson puts it over. Lockie will set. Down for the kill was Juliana Lentz, the junior from Miami, Florida. Had 2 kills in her last game versus Jacksonville State. Already up to 4 here. Feltz one more time to serve. Johnson goes low, keeps it up. Ferguson, far side, Scherfranz off at a deflection off number 10, Chelsea Lockie. And Scherfranz gets credit with that kill and puts her one closer to Manu Johnson. Up to 7 here so far tonight. Mia Freeman on the serve here for Kennesaw State. 4 aces to her name coming into the weekend. Out of bounds. Juliana Lentz looked for this near sideline, was unable to find it. Freeman will get to do it again. Goes to Feltz, Lockie, Clark. The hard hit ball directly at Shelby Dennis.
Yep, I love the way Lockley's already dishing the ball to her team. She's pushing the middle, she's trying to feed the middle a lot. And then that allows her to throw that ball back to Lauren Clark and for her to have a very open, hard hit wide swing.
Next note on the serve. Scherfranz blocked at the net but kept up. Axner one more time. Finding the middle of the floor was Lauren Clark. Ranked 6 in total kills in 2021 and finds one there. She's up to 7 and enters the 3-way tie for team kill lead. Axner on the serve here for the Eagles. Freeman will pop it up. Ferguson will set it far side. Manu Johnson finds the floor. Back and forth we go here in set three, tied 3-3.
A beautiful swing right there. You heard the defensive players behind Manu telling her swing seam, and that's why it was wide open, straight to the seam of the blockers on FGCU.
Cody back in here in her third set to serve here for Kennesaw State. Goes low with Feltz having to get it. Blocked at the net by Scherfranz. Owl's going to set up Manu Johnson on the far side. Takes a deflection. Axner keeps it alive. Here's Shoemaker directly at Leah Freeman. Pops it up right behind her on the set to Scherfranz. And here comes FGCU and Lauren Clark. Out of bounds. Hits the referee shoe on the far side. That's Scott Thompson. And the Owls take the first lead, their first lead here in set number three, 4-3. Cody serve hits the net, forces Feltner to dive to keep it up. Clark off the hands of the blockers at the net of Jasmine Brown and Manu Johnson. 4-4, we're back tied here in set three.
Clark's off to a great start. She had a power hit where no one was home. Then she had a smart little roll shot to the middle of the court, and right there she hit power to the high hands where nobody can get that for Kennesaw.
Claire Ertl to serve, the sophomore from Indianapolis. Ferguson, Jasmine Brown blocked by Aaron Shoemaker. Made herself look big there, 5-4 Eagles lead. Kennesaw State trying to preserve this 15 straight home win streak and improve it to 16. Scherfranz misses the back line by inches. Coach Keith looks like he's going to be going back to the challenge table. His team was calling for a tip, and he'll put the card down. And Emma Scherfranz looked to our referee right here, right in front of us on the net, and kind of looked.
Yeah, they were
pretty shocked. And you see head coach Keith Chunder right there talking to him and just being, it's right in front of you. How'd you miss that one?
Yeah, I think it gets to a point to where you don't want to have to use challenges, right? Because then, you know, you're going to get to a position if you're in the fifth set, you don't have any challenges left. But Kennesaw's team definitely celebrated right away.
If you look right here whenever this ball's hit, it looks like the spin on it kind of changes just a little bit.
I think you got left hand of number 9, Shipshack, right there.
So it looks like Aaron Shoemaker will be clear this one. It'll be on Shipshack.
Right there, you kind of see her middle finger and her ring finger go back a little bit.
And you'll see it from this angle, the ball kind of dips as well right here. So it looks like it hits her hands there and the spin changes to go to a top spin after it rolls off her fingers. Call has been decided. Call has been confirmed. FGCU will retain the point. So fans unhappy with it. Emma Scherfron shaking her head. FGCU fans behind their bench clapping along with the call. FGCU takes the 2-point lead, 6-4. Ertl on the serve. Freeman receives. Ferguson sets. Scherfron goes for the kill, finds the back corner and in.
She definitely wanted the ball. She's pumped up about it. And anytime that you are so adamant that something went a certain way and it didn't and that gets taken away from you, you want to prove it.
Scherfron's up to 8 kills. On the serve, the dip hits the net. Axner keeps it up. Trying to dive and save it with Chelsea Lockley, unable to do so. Got a hand underneath it, but couldn't hit it up high enough. Emma Scherfranz will get credit with an ace there. Her second on the night. Came into the weekend with 22. Had one last night as well, so make that 25 on the season for her. Hit off of the side of her hand on that one and out of bounds. 7-6, score moves. Caroline Cole will enter back in for Kennesaw State. She'll get immediate action, receiving the serve. Ferguson on the set to Johnson. Lockie will get the set this time. Blocked at the net by Manu Johnson. Takes a deflection off an FGCU hand and rolls out of bounds. 7-7 our score. Lainey Van Treese will enter back in. Manu Johnson gets the block, now gets an opportunity to serve as 2 on the night. Stepped up in the big time moments here in the last 2 nights for games. Dennis diving to keep it up and puts it back in play. Lockie on the set, tipped over. Dennis goes low one more time. Ferguson on the set, just tried to throw it over. Lockie to Felt, blocked right. Off the deflection to Shelby Dennis's hands. Van Treese blocked again and out of bounds. Emma Shipshack and Chelsea Lockley combined. But I believe it was off the hands of Shipshack and out of bounds. Owls retake the lead. It's 8-7. Lainey Van Treese gets another kill. She's up to 6 here tonight. And on the back line, Manu Johnson with the ace over the head of Claire Ertl. Thought it was going to go out of bounds and dropped directly on that back line. Free t-shirts going out here in the combo. Johnson getting ready to do it all again. Hurdle going to take that one. Set by Lockie. Johnson receives. Jasmine Brown popped up and out of bounds. Shoemaker kept alive there by Hurdle and put back in play. What a play there by FGCU in an effort. Lainey Van Treese off the hands outside. Fouls get the point.
So smart right there. Coach Keith is pumped up. Big time play right there, and then going back out, put it in a hard position right there. Van Treese was in, and she just played it smart. She's like, I don't need to kill this ball. I just need to use these hands right there and get the point.
Owls in front by three. We'll step aside for just a quick second during this timeout. Don't go anywhere. Owls and the Eagles knotted up at one here in Kennesaw. FGCU been on the court for a little bit. Owls take the full minute and 15 seconds to talk it over. Lauren, this is exactly what you want if you're Kennesaw State on a 4-0 scoring run. Manu Johnson having another great game and continues to serve really well.
Yep, keeping the momentum on their side of the court. That's what the Owls would love to do in this situation.
Hurdle receives a little bit of a bad reception, but Axner saves it, put back over. Owls gonna have a kill opportunity here with Van Treese, but blocked at the net. Areva Avive and Chelsea Lockie combining.
That just shows you how hard Lainey Van Treese hits the ball, how fast that ball came right back down on Kennesaw's side.
Here's Rylan Reed. Popped up by Ferguson. Van Treese goes for the back diving effort by Ertl to save it. Felt will go for the kill. Johnson keeps it alive. Ferguson diving. Van Treese will have to put it over. She does. Felt sets. Lockie sets. Blocked at the net by a couple of Owls. Put back over and in the corner. Lainey Van Treese. Another Owl that had a great night last night and continuing to do the same here tonight. Up to 8 kills. Jasmine Brown will exit. Claire Parsons will come in. Shelby Dennis to serve here for Kennesaw State. 30 digs last night, up to 330 on the season entering tonight.
Even though the advantage the Owls right now, FGCU is not out of this game. They are playing some insane, awesome defense, making the Owls earn these points.
Scott Thompson thought it originally was in, signaled down, but said my bad and went up. And it looks like we're going to have another challenge here on the back line.
I believe the challenge would be on a touch, not on the in and out. I do think that his correction of it being out was correct. I think that they instead thought that Aaron Shoemaker's ball caught the hands of one of the Owl blockers.
So that is what the review is going to be. So on the block, it's hard to tell if it goes through the hands. Again, it's tough to tell there. Get a better angle at it here. That doesn't look like it touches Claire Parsons' hand. It kind of looks like it.
I think it went right between the seam of McKinley Ferguson and Claire Parsons right there.
Still getting a couple more looks at it. If you watch where this ball lands, I mean, it's pretty close to being in. it's a close call. Looks like we do have a call. Call is confirmed. Kennesaw State will get the point. So the score will remain 12-8 in favor of the Owls. Owls lead in kills now 32-28. Owls with FGCU with 16 attacking errors. Kennesaw State with 9. Dennis to serve and finds an ace for herself.
Yep. Great serving call right there. Right in the mid seam of, it wasn't short, it wasn't deep, it was right in the mid zone is what we call it.
Dennis to serve, Phelps receives, Lockie sets, far side, and a great play there from Juliana Lint. Finds the open space.
Looks like we have a net violation.
Net violation, however, on FGCU, and the Owls extend their lead to 6. So Dennis will get to do it again. Hurdle receives, Lockie sets, Lintz tries to go for the same thing, takes a deflection on the block, so you don't succeed, try again, and she tried again and got that one to work.
It's always a good thing when your setter has confidence to be able to repeat after something like that. And it's always a good thing because the defensive side isn't always expecting that.
Looked like the same kind of play set up that they had originally. Manu Johnson with a hard hit ball. And touchdown there by Claire Parsons. Using all of that 6'2 height that she has to reach over and put that ball on the ground. Emma Scherfranz comes back in. McKinley Ferguson to serve, 15-9. Owls lead in set 3. Just misses the back line on that one. FGCU watched it out. Lead back down to 5. Here's Feltz on the serve. Ferguson's got it on the reception, but had enough spin on it to hit off of her hands and go over towards the scorer's table. So two straight points here for FGCU. They close it 15-11.
Yeah, we'll see if they serve Scherfranz again. They're trying to take her out of the offensive option right here, and it's a good strategy.
Two times right at her from Lily Feltz, now 15-12. Looks like Coach Keith is going to switch it up just a little bit. And this time Johnson will receive. Ferguson, Scherfranz on the kill attempt. Gets blocked at the net. Here's Shoemaker, deflection off the hands and still lands in bounds. FGCU back within 2, 15-13.
Shoemaker has always done a really good job of keeping the ball. She's such a smart player. Any game that you typically watch her play, she's going to have a high hitting percentage because she sees the court really well. She hits high hands. She's not ever trying to bring it down into the block. Very rarely does she do that. And so that's what makes her such a good player, is because she plays super smart. And she hits power when she needs to, and she just plays on when she needs to.
Kennesaw State still lead it by 2. FGCU enter this timeout from Kennesaw State on a 4-0 scoring run. If you're Emma Scherfranz in that situation where you just keep getting attacked on those serves, what do you do? What's the mindset that you have to go through to be like, how can I get out of this? Well, what can I do to try and not make these reception errors?
Yeah, I mean, if you are a hitter that is pulled back into the passing rotation, you should have the mindset that, hey, this is probably going to go to me. If you're not super confident in your serve receive, you know, I would say you don't have to be perfect in that situation. Have confidence that you have a setter like McKinley Ferguson that is very quick and is going to get to most all balls. So don't try to put it right on top of her head. Just get it high to the middle of the court, and McKinley will do something good with it.
I haven't really talked much about McKinley Ferguson here tonight. 26 assists to her name here in the middle of set number 3. Feltz still here on to serve for Florida Gulf Coast.
Yeah, you're seeing two great setters go back and forth and lead their teams really well. Lockley, a veteran, and McKinley, who has just come out of her shell this year.
There it is. Emma Scherfranz bounces back after that one. Great set there from McKinley Ferguson. Now tied with Lockie at 27 assists apiece. Freeman will come in to serve. Puts it up and over. Received by Lentz. Near side, Shoemaker right at Leah Freeman's hands. Didn't have to move him much. Sherfrons again back on the other side. Here's Clark. Blocked and almost kept alive by Leah Freeman. Went sliding for it, but unable to keep it up. 16-14. Howell still in the lead, but FGCU threatening. Here's Axner. Freeman goes low. Ferguson. Here's Sherfrons. Gets it over the hands, but popped up high. Feltz will take it. Shoemaker to hit it over. Dennis will receive. Ferguson sets. Far side. Manu Johnson off the fingertips of Aviva. She'll put it over herself. Dennis now to Sherfrons. Nice play there from Lockie to keep it alive, but slam back. Manu Johnson. 12th kill on the night.
Love the help right there. You know, Emma's hit had so much velocity on it. Just came right back over. Manu was like, I'll help you put it away.
Addie Godey in. Ready to serve. Throws it up and does just that. Feltz receives. Lockie sets. Far side for Clark. Blocked at the net by Johnson and Brown. They combine again. Just like that, the Owls get two quick points and out in front by four. Back, coming back into the game will be Emma Shipshack.
Beautiful, simple hands right there. They just hung in the air and waited. Their hands were just pressed over the net. Simple, and got her.
Godey bouncing it a couple times. Jumps and hits. And Shoemaker just watches that one land out of bounds. Substitutions for both squads. Shelby Dennis coming back in, as well as Leah Freeman. Claire Ertl to serve here. Received by Dennis, set by Ferguson. Far side for Johnson, blocked and lands out of bounds. Manu Johnson up to 13. Still got at least one more set to play. Set a new season high last night and on pace to do the same here tonight. Here's Emma Sherfrons. The top spin serve directly into the net. Third service error on Sherfrons tonight. 19 to 16. The Owls still lead by three. Here's Aaron Shoemaker. Diving play from Caroline Cole to keep it alive. Manu Johnson tried to go for the kill, but jumping up and blocking it was Chelsea Lockley. Came into tonight with 44 blocks.
Yeah, Shipshack did a really good job of reading where that ball was going, and there was no seam right there, nowhere for Manu to go.
Ferguson will set. Johnson on the light tip over. Almost falling to the floor, but Lockie saves it. Put over by Shoemaker. Ferguson goes for the kill herself directly at Ertl. This time Feltz does it. Bad hit off the top of the ball. Where Caroline Cole hit it, 19-18, and just like that, we're within one. The Eagles still trail. Low serve, Shelby Dennis receives it bad, tied 19-19. Coming down to the wire here at the Convocation Center. Coach Keith gonna call a timeout. We're gonna step aside. Final moments of set number three. Coming up here, don't go anywhere. You won't want to miss it on the KSU Owl Network.
Thank you.
after a huddle first. Back out on the court, FGCU doing the same just now. 4-0 scoring run to tie this game up at 19 here in set number three for the Owls. A 15-game home winning streak on the line. FGCU looking for a place to try and get close to that top spot in the A-Sun. Big set here. Caroline Cole receives, Ferguson sets, Brown put it over. Here's Shoemaker, Dennis goes low to receive it. So does Ferguson. Put over, here's Lockie, far side for Lily Phelps, and she gets the kill. FGCU takes the lead. Their first lead since way back in this game when they led it 6-4. Tipped over by Brown. Shoemaker puts it over. At the net, Owls get the point. Jasmine Brown.
Just hanging in the air just long enough. Gravity has no effect on that girl. She touches around 10-5, by the way. Fun fact.
Good to know now.
That's five inches over a basketball goal.
I can't even touch the rim of a basketball goal. It makes me feel short. 20-20 our score here in set three. Manu Johnson on the serve. Axner receives, set by Lockie. Here's Feltz again, blocked, but over. Owls try and do the same. Cole tried to dive and keep it up, unable to do so. And FGCU with more back and forth action on top, 21-20, with Rylan Reed coming back in to serve.
These are the moments that you practice for that you want to be in. You want to be in these high intensity back and forth moments because it's not fun to just not be competitive. And this is exactly what the Owls train for.
Ferguson to Brown. Keeping it close, Kennesaw State had the lead up until late in this set. FGCU gets a point, takes the lead, Owls come back and tie. Owls looking for a lead here. Shelby Dennis on the serve. Phelps receives, Lockie sets. Here's Phelps. Ferguson got her hands up there, but off the outside of him and out of bounds. FGCU on top, 22-21.
Yep, it seemed as if the Owls block was a little bit late. Phelps had a lot of line to work with or a lot of arm to use right there to swipe it off of him.
Here's Chelsea Lockie on the serve. Dennis will pop it up for Ferguson. She tries to throw it over with Claire Parsons going in on the attack, but kind of just throws it into the net. 23-21, now the Owls have some work to do.
Looked a little bit low for Claire Parsons, high reach right there, so she tried to do something with it really quick, but everyone's taking a deep breath right here and looking to side out before they get it 24.
Sure, Franz coming out. She'll receive it, get a little bit of redemption. Far side, Van Treese finds the floor. Owls not going away. Here's Ferguson getting ready to serve here for Kennesaw State. Up in the air and over, just off the top of the net actually. Didn't get enough on it. And now we're at match point here for FGCU. And Lily Phelps on the serve. Gonna be Manu Johnson to receive if they target her. And that's where it's going. Johnson pops up, Ferguson over for Van Treese. Point going to FGCU, Owls claiming touch. Doesn't look like Kennesaw State is going to challenge, so the Owls down 2-1 here after three sets. Got some work to do here, Lauren. What is Coach Keith going to tell his team in the huddle?
I think he's going to tell them to, hey, this is what a championship game feels like, and to take it in and to love competing every single point, because that's what we're feeling right now. Like, Kennesaw is playing really well. FGCU is playing really well. And everyone's making big-time plays right now, and that's what it will feel like in a few weeks when they head up to Nashville to try to play for a championship. And so I don't think that he gets onto them in these big moments. Instead, he's like, let's work through this. Let's learn through this, and this is what we practice for. This is what y'all want.
Set number four on the way. Owls trail 2-1 here from the Convocation Center. More action coming your way from the KSU Convocation Center.
I was late this morning.
Sorry, guys.
I'm pretty organized.
I'd say both.
I'd say different things. I don't know. We're both just hilarious.
We're both the funniest people ever. Yeah, and both things, right?
They go hand in hand. You're a bad driver, you're funny. You're a good driver,
it's automatic,
sorry.
Yeah.
I think I have.
Yeah.
I started when I was 9, playing like club.
Yeah, I started freshman year of high school.
We're both bad.
Yeah,
neither. We can't say either, or else they will all disagree.
Yeah, they will all give us crap about it. Yeah.
Bad drivers, these two right here. I think I am.
I don't know.
We're having a cook-off.
Yeah, we're gonna have a cook-off now.
We'll talk to Coach about that. That's gonna be a side.
Yeah,
not
side.
Main,
we're
not main
making
dish,
a whole
side.
Dish. Yeah. Yeah. Five course meal.
Yeah. Neither.
Neither, yeah.
We're both just clean freaks. Chelsea.
Back at the Convocation Center, Kennesaw State trails. Two sets to one. FGCU looking for a big win. Owls looking to extend their home win streak to 16. All comes down to this. Owls need the set to extend the game. Leah Freeman to serve here for Kennesaw State. Received by Shoemaker. Net by... So we're going to have a violation there on Kennesaw State. FGCU will get the point. Dana Axner on the serve here for the Eagles. Freeman goes low. Johnson had to lean back into it a little bit. Here's Lockie and Clark directly at the floor. Leah Freeman tried to get low, but was unable to do so and deflects it out of bounds. FGCU out to an early 2-0 lead.
What a beautiful swing right there by Clark, right here in front of us. It was so clean, so powerful.
Here's Axner again, Freeman to receive, Ferguson to set. Claire Parsons right close, tried to get it, but blocked directly in front. Another block at the net by Lockie, and I believe
Shipshack
was over there as well. Scherfron just couldn't get it over or around the hands. FGCU out to an early 3-0 lead. Axner again on the serve. Ferguson to set, far side, Manu Johnson, pen violation. Owls finding not a lot of luck here right now. Down 4-0 and set 4.
Yeah, down 2-1 right here. You kind of want to come out really hot this fourth set. Letting FGC know that you're going to put up a fight, that we're going to take this to 5 no matter what.
Off the net, Ferguson had to be there in good position. Scherfrons, far side, trying to find the floor, can't do it. Lockie on the set, Shoemaker blocked, unable to get down. Freeman for Ferguson, Claire Parsons diving to save it, and sliding underneath was Lockie. Here's Clark, blocked at the net, Axner keeps it alive. This time it's Feltz, violation, can't point Kennesaw State, a much needed point.
A great swing right there by Feltz, but she's out of the back row, so she has to take off. She has to jump behind that 10-foot line. No part of her foot can be touching that line, and some of her toes were on that line when she took flight.
Addie Godey back in to serve here for the Owls. Clark on the attack, gets blocked at the net. Put over, Godey sets. Same with Ferguson, still kept alive. Ferguson, far side. Scherfranz just misses the back line. 5-1 in favor of FGCU.
Shipshot covered that ball with her back. Lauren Clark went up to hit it, and she just ducked her head, and it bounced perfectly right off her back.
Chelsea Abel making her way into the game here for Kennesaw State. Well, maybe she looked like she was for a second.
That's the old sneaky libero change.
Ferguson, Jasmine Brown, couple of deflections. Has to be put over, and it is. Ferguson sets. Johnson, deflection again. FGCU hanging around. Shoemaker almost a near right off of the face of Shelby Dennis. Had to just get her hands up and protect herself. Ball goes out of bounds. Owls now trail by 5. Here's Ertl on the serve. Diving to keep it up was Freeman. Put over by Brown. Here's Lockie, far side. Shoemaker again, blocked at the net by 2 Owls. Lockie. This time it's Shipshack, but out of bounds. Owls again get a much needed point. Scherfranz to serve. Owls trail by 4, 6-2. But she'll be taken out for Caroline Cole.
The Eagles are playing amazing defense right now and keeping the ball in system. Lockley is dishing the ball really well to her teammates, and we feel that Kennesaw is more so on the opposing, just scrapping around, trying to keep up with them right now.
Cole with 8 aces coming into this weekend. Deflection called off the hands of the blockers at the net for Kennesaw State. Point will go to FGCU and back trailing by 5. Shoemaker received by Freeman, popped up by McKinley Ferguson, blocked at the net, and just finding the line was FGCU and Ertl. Kennesaw State going to need a much-needed timeout here, which they are going to take. 8-2 the score as we will take a quick break. Owls have some work to do to try and climb back in this one. You're watching Kennesaw State Women's Volleyball here on KSU Owl Network. GCU digging deep here and putting a pounding here on Kennesaw State. A lead by 6 and set number 4 with a chance to clinch this match and a much needed win. As we get closer to the A-Sun tournament, Lauren, you and I were talking about it during the break. It looks like FGCU is just finding a way no matter what to get these points.
Really in control right now.
Big point there as Jasmine Brown finds the floor.
Yep, that's exactly what you want to see coming out of a good timeout called right there. Just kind of switching some momentum, allowing your team, hey, we're still here, we're still in it. We have a long way to go to 25.
Johnson to serve, 13 kills to her name. 1 ace as well. Ertl will receive. Lockley will pop it up. Far side for Feltz. Nice job by Dennis to keep it alive. Here's Van Treese. Wanted a touch, didn't. Get one call, left it long. Back trailing by 6, 9-3, FGCU on top. Ryland Reed makes her way back in to serve. 901 kills and 105 aces in high school. Van Treese finds the middle of the four and FGCU couldn't really do much about it. Brings her up to her 10th kill. Two straight games with double-digit kills for Lainey Van Treese.
She's crushing the ball. She's seeing the court well. I love the response after an error. She just stayed in her bubble.
Chelsea Abel into the game here for Kennesaw State. Nice job by Freeman to keep it alive. Van Treese tips it over. Ertl. Abel tries to pop it over off the net and in, is able to. Blocked by Chelsea Abel. Ferguson with the kill.
The perfect opportunity to turn and do that. She has not been as effective offensively tonight as we've seen her be in past games, and that was a perfect time to turn and crank on that ball.
Owls finding a way back in. They trail by 4, 9-5. Dennis on the serve. Set by Lockie. Cole keeps it up. Ferguson, far side, tipped over by Van Treese. Just misses out of bounds. It was close, but not quite getting any part of that white line. Here's Chelsea Lockie to serve.
I think I'm more impressed of how she kept her body out of the way from hitting that ball while she was in mid-dive.
Fifth year from Eaton, Colorado. Cole to Ferguson. Manu Johnson from the back line finds it. 14 kills for Manu Johnson. Emma Scherfranz comes back in. McKinley Ferguson to serve. Came in this weekend, I should say, 20th in the A-Sun and Aces. But service aces are killing the Owls here tonight. That's Ferguson's fourth.
Yeah, Coach Keith teaches and coaches a more aggressive side of serving, and sometimes it always pays off, and sometimes it produces more risk than reward.
Can't make it up much better than that. Owls receive the serve. Ferguson comes over, sets, and Scherfranz gets the easy kill.
Pumped up about that one.
Trailed by 6 early on, closing it down to 4 slowly, 11-7. Eagles lead in set number 4. Bryce Gobert, Lauren Chastang here with you from the Convocation Center. Lockie sets, far side, Shoemaker, deflection off the block from Abel, and Scherfranz lands out of bounds. FGCU will get the point and extend their lead back to 5. Freeman receives the serve. Manu Johnson on the attack. Diving effort by Axner to keep it alive. Felt's able to do so and put back over by Lockie. Ferguson sets. Far side. Manu Johnson directly at Lockie. Here's Axner. Now Shoemaker blocked to the net by Abel and Scherfranz. Lockie one more time. Both Scherfranz and Abel there still being popped around. Put over by Felt's. Owl's going to have to do the same with Manu Johnson. Deflected at the net. Axner, here's Clark, blocked at the net, still kept alive by FGCU. Shoemaker this time blocked, and they finally get it to hit the floor.
Like, finally, is kind of what their response was as a victory celebration. Great job by Shoemaker, keeping the ball high. Again, like I talked about earlier, she does a great job of not pulling the ball down and just making balls playable and play-ons, even when she's in a bad situation.
First time we'll see Danny Ballou tonight. Freeman tries to save it, unable to do so. That goes down as an ace for Axner. And just as the Owls were getting close, FGCU back out to a 7-point lead and a must-win set here for Kennesaw State. Freeman receives. Ferguson behind her. Danny Ballou almost had the kill. Lockie went low. Ferguson sets. Ballou one more time, directly at Axner. Clark puts it over. Ferguson, near side. Manu Johnson finds the corner.
I love that whole rally by the Owls. A very hard hit by Danny Ballou. Another very hard hit by Danny Ballou. And then shoot it out to the opposite pin to Manu to put it away.
Chelsea Abel and Shelby Dennis will come out for Addie Godey. Yasmin Brown works her way in as well. directly at Feltz. Far side for Shoemaker. Deflection off the block. Ferguson, Johnson, able to put it over. Almost hitting the floor. Shoemaker this time. Freeman with a great diving save. Here's Danny Ballou. Feltz able to return it. And tip back over by FGCU's number 9, Emma Shipsack. Redshirt junior from Maquon, Wisconsin. 9 kills in her previous game against Jacksonville State. Freeman receives, Ferguson sets. Manu Johnson, deflection. Great play there from Feltz to keep it alive. Ferguson, Danny Ballou, light tip over. Lockie there to pop it up. Axner does the same. Here's Shoemaker, blocked by a couple of owls and landing inbounds. Danny Ballou and Jasmine Brown there at the block. Owls trying to keep this one close. Lauren being in a must-win set situation and down by 6. What is it like as a player just trying to keep calm?
I think you just have to think of it as the perspective as one ball at a time. You can only earn 1 point at a time anyways, right? And so, you know, a harder hit ball doesn't count for more points. And so just being very simple and just staying within each point at a time and not thinking about how much distance there is between the scores really, really helps.
Florida Gulf Coast takes a timeout. Owls close the lead to 5. Taking a look at kind of everyone on this Kennesaw State team. Danny Ballou didn't play much last night. Coming in a crucial set here tonight and already finds herself with 1 kill on 4 attacks. I mean, you got to come in the clutch. And with her, she's doing just that. Owls just trying to find a way right now. 3 players in double-digit kills. 15 kills for Manu Johnson, 10 for Lainey Vantrease, 10 for Emma Scherfrantz. Owls are just trying to fight and battle. And from earlier on in the set, this looks like a little bit of a different, more confident team.
Yep, absolutely. I think it was a good idea to bring in Danny Ballou. I think she's the leader on the team. I think she fires the team up in a lot of ways. And also, her court presence just makes everyone a little bit more confident, a little bit more calm. And because of that, right, they're going to be able to maybe find a different type of mojo that they haven't had all night.
Owls are looking to keep a 6-15 game home winning streak alive and extend it to 16. But they need to win this set and force the 5th set to 15 to try and have a chance. Danny Ballou, Leah Freeman, McKinley Ferguson, Shelby Dennis, Jasmine Brown, and Manu Johnson on the floor.
And we also talked about this yesterday in reverse roles, but that's a good thing about having a deep team where, you know, Danny, Lainey, Manu, they can all be kind of interchangeable and all bring something to the court no matter who's hot, who's not.
Ballou on the serve. Blocked at the net by Brown, but off her and out of bounds, so FGCU gets the point, extending their lead back to 6. Owls going to need to string together a run. Here's Shoemaker, left it way long. You see Lainey Vantrease coming back in for Leah Freeman. Manu Johnson going to get to serve. FGCU leads. Here's Johnson on the serve. Hurdle has to go low. Lockie on the set. Far side for Lily Feltz. Deflection on the way out and landing out of bounds. So FGCU gets the point. They still lead by 6. Rylan Reed on the serve. Cole receives, far near side, Lainey Vantrease kept alive. Put over, dug out of there by Vantrease. Dennis will have to put it over. Lockie far side for Feltz, blocked. Now FGCU will have to do the same and put it over. Ferguson with a chance to set. Far side for Vantrease, didn't get enough on it, just has to tip it over, rode on the net a little bit. Going up for the block. Manu Johnson with a great save. Van Treese tries to find the corner, but hits it too hard and out of bounds.
A lot of back and forth right there. A lot of good volleyball. If you're Laney, you're in the middle of a really long rally. It's hard to get transitioned out right there. And so she didn't have her typical approach to the ball right there and previously was put in not the best situations, right? So.
Owls trail by 7. Ferguson crossed underneath the net while trying to put it over. I think that one would have been out if Caroline Cole didn't touch it. And now the Owls trail by 8, 19-11. Head coach Keith Schonzel to call a timeout. I mean, the stats, if you look at them, have, from where we started, changed a lot. Owls leading kills 45-44. FGCU with 22 attacking errors. Kennesaw with 19. Owls hitting 187. FGCU hitting 162.
Yep, and what has really started to hurt the Owls more so in these last two sets than anything is all the errors that they have started to accumulate here. At first, especially at the first set, we saw that FGCU led that category by a lot, and now everything has evened out. And later in the match, and that's not what you want to see going into the fourth set. Instead, you would like to see everything get a little bit cleaned up and offense getting hotter and hotter.
Owls with some work to do, 19-11. They trail. Win streak on the line. Need a big win here against FGCU. You've mentioned it a lot, Lauren. This is like a final atmosphere. This is what you're going to face in Nashville if you get there. And that's what you're working for all season. How can you overcome adversity?
Yeah, and I think that it's always smart if this doesn't go the way that they wanted it to. This is where it's a learning opportunity, and you know what? You're just thankful it's not Nashville that you're in when you have to learn your lessons, right? And so you can learn lessons early before it's a season ender versus a streak ender. Like, at the end of the day, the streak is cool, but it's not what actually matters for these girls at the end of the day.
Rylan Reed with a hard serve received by Dennis. Jasmine Brown misses it long again. 5 points away are FGCU. They now lead by 9. Reed again on the serve, received by Dennis. Near side for Van Treese. She puts the power behind it. Pretty sure that had a little bit of flames coming off of it. Owls now trail by 8.
That was an amazing swing. I think she had only one blocker up, so she was able to just hit as hard as she can and showcase that. And as the crowd felt, as everyone felt, she can hit that ball hard.
Dennis on the serve. Hurdle didn't have it too clean, but able to return and set it up for a spike on the far side, or a kill on the far side by Feltz. Now 4 points away, still leading by 9. KSU with no timeouts.
Feltz has done a great job of just continuing to be her, and she's made her way back into this game of being someone that's producing for her offense.
Ferguson to Johnson, finds the back part of the white line. 21-13. 8-point lead here for FGCU. Like I said, Kennesaw State gonna need a run. McKinley Ferguson to serve. Danny Blue and Chelsea Abel back in. That one finds the back line. McKinley Ferguson gets an ace.
Yeah, just a little bit of topspin on it that made it fall off the shelf right there at the last second.
All FGCU could do was watch. 14-21. A little bit of a pause here. Debating a coach's challenge was Matt Botsford. Decides against it. 7-point lead for the Eagles. Feltz receives. Lockie sets. Far side for Feltz. Blocked at the net. Popped around. The Owls get the point. Another timeout here for FGCU. The final one of the set for them. We're going to step aside here. Let the teams take a timeout. We'll take a breather as well and allow you to do the same at home. Owls trail by 6. 21-15 here in set number 4 in a must-win set from the Convocation Center. back at the Convocation Center. Owls force FGCU into a timeout on a 3-0 run. Kennesaw State trying to stay alive and force a fifth set. 21-15 the score here in set number four. Kinley Ferguson still on the serve. 38 assists tonight, 2 kills. And just got a service ace to her name as well. Deep breath, throws it up off the net. Locke sets, Feltz goes for the kill. Ferguson does the splits to try and save it. Just above the head of Lainey Van Treesen hits the pin. 22-15. FGCU's lead back out to 7. Here's Lily Feltz on the serve, the outside hitter. Received by Dennis, set from Ferguson. Tipped over by Ballou, jumped a little bit early. Here's Clark, diving to save it as Manu Johnson puts it over, but no Owl was there as they were all committed to trying to save that ball, and an easy kill there for Florida Gulf Coast.
Yeah, great heads up play right there by Aaron Shoemaker. It wasn't a high overset ball where you have lots of time, like I talked about earlier, where the timing can be weird because you're just waiting so long for the ball. Instead, she just had a really quick arm swing, and those are the easiest kills when no one's up to block and no one's ready for it.
23-15, FGCU leads and still serving. Here's Feltz, received by Dennis. Ferguson will set. Manu Johnson finds the back line. Came from the back, jumped before the line. Able to find the power to get behind it. No team with any timeouts remaining. So we're going this one timeout free pending a review. 23-16. Owls trail by 7. Freeman on the serve. Kept up by Freeman. Ferguson will set. Here's Manu Johnson with the light tip. Shoemaker goes for the kill and gets it on the deflection. FGCU now has match points. Dana Axner on the serve. Freeman sets it. So does Ferguson. Ballou puts it over. Here's Lockie on the set. Far side, Shoemaker blocked to the net by Abel and Ballou. One more time for Shoemaker. Ferguson keeps it alive. Dennis will set it, and Ballou will just have to put it over. Axner, Lockie set backwards for Clark. Ferguson pops it up. Owls trying to force at least one more point. Lockie, Shoemaker finds the inside line. And FGCU will take this one 25-16 in set four and beat the Owls 3-1 here at the Convocation Center, ending the Owls' 15-game home win streak here tonight. Tied for the longest, or that was the longest in team history. Exactly. Kennesaw State just wasn't close enough, had a really good set number one. But sets 2, 3, and 4 just couldn't find a way to quite close it out. A tough one there, Lauren. And not the way that you want to lose that kind of game, but nonetheless, a very good effort there from Kennesaw State.
No, I'm sure if you're Kennesaw State, you knew that this was going to be a hard game coming into it. And we're about to hear from Coach Keith right now, just some thoughts about it, and obviously not happy about it.
Getting everything set up right now. Coach, tough loss for your team in this one, ending the win streak at home, but we were talking about it during the broadcast. That's not what it's about. It's about how you can overcome these kind of losses and move on. How do you feel that your team will be able to do that?
Well, you know, first, I think you saw a game that could have been the championship game right there. And I'm not saying these two teams are going to be in it, but that was the level of that match. You know, I think we had a chance to really not close the door, but put ourselves in a great position. We're up 19-16 in the third to go up 2-1 and dominating that set.
Yeah.
And we didn't finish that set. And, you know, I want our team to learn from that moment. And then there's a reason they were picked first. There's a reason they've won a couple times in the last few years. They're really good. And they got rolling, and we did not finish that third, and then the fourth happened. So I'm proud of our team. We've gotten tremendously better. We're playing really good volleyball. We played some of the best volleyball of the year tonight. You know, we got beat, and then the fourth got away from us. But proud of our women. You know, we're we're learning. We're playing hard. We got to learn from some stuff that happened there in that match.
Manu Johnson with another monster night, 17 kills. Players like her, Lainey Van Treese with another night of double-digit kills. We talked about it last night with that depth. What is it like? And I know it's kind of the same question, but back-to-back nights now, they've shown these kind of performances. Now you can rely on them if needed and later on in the season.
For sure, and that's what you're going to need as we come down the stretch here. You know, if somebody's not getting it done, we're going to need somebody else to come in and get it done. We have a little bit of a challenge right now because we've got a lot of pins playing really well. And so that's kind of on the coaching staff. The girls' job is they need to keep competing. And when it's their numbers called, they get out there and make it happen. But depth is good. Depth is a great problem to have.
Lauren, you got anything?
I was just going to say that y'all definitely are very, very rolling on the offensive side. Y'all actually outplayed them on the offensive side as a whole, even when it's all said and done. And they kind of crept away on the dig, so defensively they kept up more things and stayed in system more, definitely towards the end. And so I told him, you know, it's better now to lose a streak versus losing in Nashville. And what do you think that you're going to walk in there and tell your girls after something that they obviously wanted to come in and know that y'all can absolutely beat FGCU, even though it didn't happen tonight?
Sure. You know, the streak isn't something that you guys talk about that. I didn't even know it until that's kind of been a thing. So yeah. That's not something our locker room has talked about. You are correct, Lo, that the defensive side of the ball was where they really cranked up. You know, statistically, the blocks were even. We out-hit them most of the night. You know, they really turned it up defensively. And that kind of changed the tone of that match. And Axner played great, and a bunch of them played great on defensive, on the defensive side. But I'm gonna tell them to keep their heads up. You know, there are 6, 7, 8 teams that could win this thing, and we are without question one of them. You know, it's a tough loss. There's gonna be some disappointed people in there, some upset people. But that's how it goes. These seasons are tough. They're long. There's a lot of good teams. It's the deepest league we've ever had. And Gulf Coast is good. They're well coached, and sometimes it goes that way. So we'll be all right.
Well, Coach, a tough loss. Appreciate you taking the time after this game to sit down with us, and it's always a pleasure.
Thanks, y'all.
Yeah. We'll now go ahead and take a look at the final stats here. FGCU ends up edging Kennesaw State in kills with 49, Kennesaw State with 48. FGCU did still lead in attacking years, 23-20. Owls finished with a one hitting percentage of 190, FGCU with 178. Lauren, looking at these stats, again, I feel like I always ask you this, but standout sets do you think changed the game here tonight?
I think players like Lily Feltz, who just stay consistent, you know, Aaron Shoemaker, who was a vengeance all night, and especially towards the fourth set, we saw just how smart and how much of a veteran player she is, and even Lauren Clark. So those people started to pull away, and we talked about that in the third set. No one really from FGCU started to pull away until towards the end, right? And then Manu Johnson was very consistent all night. Everyone else kind of died off at the end of the fourth set, and so that consistency kind of fell off the table a little bit, like Coach Keith talked about.
Owls unable to extend the win streak, as Coach said. It wasn't really on his mind. He was kind of just looking to try and get this win and focus on moving forward. FGCU wins 3-1. Owls take set number one, 25-17. FGCU 25-21, 25-22, 25-16. For Bryce Gobert, for Lauren Chastang, I'm Bryce Gobert saying thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you for the final home game on November 13th. So long, everyone.